Hi, welcome to Not a Chef. I'm your host, Mick J. And what we're here to do is teach you that low-carb food, diet food, doesn't have to be boring. It can be exciting, it can be beautiful, it can be tasty food. And exciting, tasty food allows people to stay on their diets longer. So that's what we're here to do. And today, what we're gonna do is we're gonna make fish tacos, but we're not gonna make just any fish tacos. We're gonna make swordfish tacos. Swordfish tacos. Swordfish is a great fish for low carb diets, especially, you know, the keto diet, which is what I'm on. I'm still going to be on it a little while longer. I got to work on that. But for the keto diet, it's great because you've got swordfish has this great. It's high in protein. It's high in fat. It's, you know, no carb. And it's got omega-3 fatty acids and omega-6s in there. So it's really, really good for a keto-style diet or any kind of low-carb Atkins, stuff like that. So what we're going to do here is for the swordfish, all we really need is a swordfish steak, which you get, this one's about 3/4 of a pound, you get in between 3/4 to a quarter to a full pound. So what you want to do is it's about a quarter pound per taco, because we're going to make three out of this. Yeah, they're going to be big honking tacos, but they're going to be so good. Then what we're going to do here is we've got, I've got a pan here with some olive oil already in it. And what we're going to do is go ahead and crank that up. It's been heating, you know, preheating a little bit. We're going to crank that up to 7 on an electric stove, because most people are still, you know, I'm stuck in an apartment, you know, so I can't have gas in here, or, you know, I haven't found an apartment with gas in it here. So I've got an electric stove, and you crank that up to 7, which is medium high. And you let that the oil come up to temperature. And then what we're going to do here is for the swordfish, we're just going to salt and pepper it. Just take, and I use, you can use sea salt. I use coarse kosher salt. That's about all I use anymore. It's fantastic, and the large grains really stick to it, and it really tends to, it doesn't oversalt the food. It just brings out the flavors in the food better. And then I'm using one of the little grinders you can buy that's a peppercorn medley grinder. So it's got like 9 different kinds of peppercorns in here. It's great. So, and I have that set to medium coarse, and just put a nice coating of that on there. Give it a little pat there. All right, I'm gonna take that, and when the oil starts smoking here, that means that's how we know that it's ready for the swordfish. So what we're gonna do, and for the swordfish, what we're gonna do is we want to get to a nice golden brown on all sides, including the edges. We'll end up searing the edges too. We're gonna sear it, and then we set it off and let it rest. And it'll cook just like a normal steak does. So you can sear it on all sides and get it set up. And while we're waiting for the oil to get ready, which is actually pretty close to getting ready since I had to preheat it a little bit. While the oil is getting ready, the other thing we're going to do here is we're on the tacos, we're going to have homemade guacamole. Homemade guacamole is awesome. It's just awesome for all kinds of reasons. Number one is avocados, which high in fat, really good for a keto diet. I've already got 2 of them set up here, but you're going to need avocados, of course, 3 avocados, some about 1/3 of a teaspoon to 1/2 teaspoon of garlic powder, the same for onion powder. You have 1/4 teaspoon of cayenne pepper, and then salt and pepper to taste. And also, we're gonna need a lime too. So what we're gonna do here is, we've already got 2 of them done, so you're gonna take the 3rd one, get it, and slice it open around the perimeter. Once you get that open, and you just do twist it, and it should pop right open like that. So look at that, beautiful, beautiful. You set one of those over, and here's another little trick to get the pit out of it without end up chewing up the meat on the inside of it, is you pop it right in the middle there, or, you know, near the middle, and twist it, and there you go. There's your pit. Seed is right out of there. And then take a nice big spoon, haul it out here, and then ta-da, there you go. That's one, ooh, that's a little spot in there. I'm gonna get that out. That doesn't mean that the whole thing is done. That just means that that's a spot that apparently had gone bad, and then we need to get rid of that. All right, set that over there, and do the same for the other half. Get that into place there too. If you look at those and they look brown right there, that's because they've been sitting out because I pre-prepped it and didn't stick it in the fridge. But they're still okay. They're still good. It's not going to get you sick or bad for you or anything like that. So what we're doing over here, okay, now this is smoking. This is ready to go. This is absolutely ready to go. So what we're going to do is we're going to take the side of the swordfish that we've already seasoned. We take it and put that sucker down right there, making a lot of noise. That's how you know it's good. So we're going to do that. And while that side's searing, then you salt and pepper the other side. Season the other side of it. God, if you could smell this right now, it's absolutely gorgeous. So what we're gonna do here is let that sit, and it's gonna toast itself up there, sear the sides nice and good. And that's gonna be a few minutes on each side, and no more than 3 minutes on each side, because this is a decently thick piece, but they cook quickly. So while we already got those done, and move that out of the way, I'll stick the salt over here, because we'll need that in a second. And I've got a piece of tin foil, aluminum foil, and what I do is I actually create a little pocket when I let these rest so it holds the heat in better and allows it to finish resting and finish cooking correctly. So we got here, we take this, we've already got the avocados in there, so we go ahead and chop those up and chew just get it to where it's, you know, a basic decent chop to where it's all chunks in here. It's gonna be loud. It's gonna be loud. This is how you know you're cooking good, because good cooking is never quiet. Good cooking is never ever quiet. So good. So there we go. See, it's chunked up there pretty well. So I can actually put that over here. Now, what we're gonna do is I'll leave the lime for a second. We'll go ahead and take, I put about a third of a teaspoon to a half a teaspoon of salt in mine. Not quite as much pepper, but close. Just give a nice good coating over here. There we go. Now I'll take, about a quarter teaspoon of cayenne pepper. And then about a half a teaspoon of onion powder. And then about a half a teaspoon of garlic powder. You can always go a little bit heavier with the garlic. Garlic's fine. So what we do here is, while this stuff is cooking, we will double check this to see how the downside is doing, if I can get a hold of it. Oh yeah, that is beautiful. That is just about perfect. So go ahead and turn that over and let the other side sear down. So see, this stuff cooks really fast. We're talking like 2 to 3 minutes max on each side. While we go to that, we'll go ahead, we're gonna slice our lime in half. The first thing we do is we take it and roll it on the counter like this. That breaks down the berries inside and allows it to be juiced easier. It's an old bartender trick. And take that, slice that puppy open right there. And since this is three of them, we're gonna use the juice from the whole lime. You don't have to squeeze it down too hard to get super all the juice out, because you are using the juice from the whole lime. But you go ahead and squeeze it. Squeeze it down here. There we go. Give it another double squeeze, get the last little bit out of there. There we go. Lime juice. Ooh, that's looking really good. That's getting close over there. So after you've got all that in place, so you got the limes and so, and then basically you just do a good mash on it here. So just make sure you thoroughly inundate this, get it all completely mixed together, and it's going to come out chunky. That's the whole thing, is like, this is how you know, it's kind of like homemade mashed potatoes. You don't always know you got the good stuff, and you know you got the real stuff when it's chunky. So you're gonna have some chunks in here, and that is just fine. That's the way it's supposed to be. So just get a good mash on here. I mean, you don't want it too chunky. You don't want to have like giant chunks sitting there. But, you know, having visible chunks, not a bad thing. Plus, you want to get all the spices and everything completely mixed around through there. So, take a tap taste of this. We got it. Solid. All right. Guacamole. Set that off to the side. Well, I've got that off to the side. Go back over here and double check on this. It should be just about ready to sear the edges. Yeah, there we go. We'll take this, hold it up. You sear the edges. Another one gets a little loud. Loud cooking is good cooking. Get the sear. And you don't have to sear the edges for near as long as you do either side, because it's, you know, I don't remember the science behind it, but it tends to sear pretty quickly. I mean, you're talking it's usually about no more than about 30 seconds to a minute on each edge, but probably closer to 30 seconds. Set that up the edge. While that's doing that, actually, and take this. You've noticed, if you don't be freaking out, because I've got three different towels down here and I use them for different things, so there's no cross contamination or anything like that. And that's part of the reason also that I use the tin foil when I'm doing this, is because I want to make sure that, you know, you're not putting, you know, your cooked fish back where you had raw fish before. Not very sanitary. Take that. There we go. That's pretty. All right. I want you to get this up on the edge there. Let the other edge sear. Now I may lay it back down over a little bit. And now what we're going to do is put on it for our final touches. We're going to use the sauce. And the sauce is ridiculously simple. It's a great dipping sauce for a french fries, for anything else you want to do. I use it on the fish tacos because it's really tasty. There's only two things you need. Mayonnaise and hot sauce. I use Sriracha. Actually, I use a bunch of different kinds because I've got a whole crap load of them. Most of them are Chipotle based because I freaking love Chipotle. Chipotle peppers. Nah, the food's not too bad either. So, in here, and with this, it's about a 50-50 mix. So we'll take, you know, a couple of tablespoons. Put that right in there of the mayo. And then get about an equal mix of Sriracha. Shake it up first. Make sure you get that vinegary and a nice mix in there. Take this. There we go. Yeah, baby. That's how you do it. Close this back down. Put this over in a special Sriracha corner. All right. Let's check this. Beautiful. Get the one last little bit that needs to sear. There. Yeah. And the simple bit of this is all you have to do here is just mix. Oh, perfect. Takes that the mayo takes the Sriracha, and you still leave the fire in there, but it adds a nice creamy texture to it. So get one of each of these sizes of spoons out here because I'll need them in just a minute. Set that off to the side. We are done with that knife. Set this over here. All right. Looking at this, looks pretty close to done. Yeah, baby. I'm gonna lay this back down on either face for about 15-20 seconds. And get that beautiful, beautiful olive oil, inundated olive oil floating around through there. The nice sides all nice and cut. And then one more. There we go. So look at that beautiful brown. And nice crispy edges. Just, oh, gorgeous. Absolutely gorgeous. So, What we're going to do with this is, once this is done, in a few seconds here, we're going to take this off and put it in the tin foil to let it rest the rest of the way. You know, about 5 minutes or so. Shouldn't even take that long. So, there we go. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. We're going to take this, put it in the middle right there. You know, lean this over. Now, I'm going to make a little pocket out of this. Basically just fold it up in place here. At the end. I do this with steak as well, because it works. It's really, really good. A lot of people say, y'all just cover it. It's like, actually make a little pocket out of it, because that allows for it to really hold the heat in and cook nicely. Finish cooking nicely. So, while that's there, let's finish it up. So now what we need are our tortillas, because you can't have tacos without tortillas. And I'm going to make a total endorsement here. I use Mission Brand Carb Balance tortillas, and these are the soft taco size. I also have the fajita size. These are 6 net grams of carbs each. The smaller ones are 4. The fajita size are 4. So I've got 3 of these left, which is just perfect because that's what we need. Take these puppies and lay them out. Some people would heat them up. I don't necessarily, you know, it's, the problem is that, you know, if I did it on the stove over here, it would probably dry them out. Well, actually it would dry them out. And I don't want to do that because then they crinkle and crackle whenever you, fold them up to eat. So what I'm going to do is now is get out. I use salad mix. I use mixed green salad mix. This is a 50-50 mix. It's got baby spinach, radicchio, arugula. I don't think it's got any frisée in there, but it's got some stuff that looks kind of like frisée. I'm not exactly sure. You know, I need to brush up on all my leafy greens. So what we're going to do is put that back over here for a second. And the first thing we want to do is we're going to take a dollop of this beautiful guacamole. Take it here. And put a nice coat on there. You don't want to put too much, you don't want to put too little. You put too much, you end up squeezing it out all over the place whenever you, you know, fold it up and start munching into it. You don't want that to happen. You know, messy food's okay, but I just, you know, I've ruined way too many shirts like that, so it's not something. It can start to get expensive after a while. So you're going to do that with all 3 of these like this. You know, there's that chunky avocado. That. So a dollop. Used about a tablespoon to a tablespoon and a half per. You know, and that gives you decent coverage. It's also, it's a nice, beautiful green color. So, in addition to being tasty, it's actually really beautiful too, and helps bring out the color, the rest of the colors in the dish, which you will see are absolutely gorgeous here in a minute. So, take that. That's a good mix. So now we take our greens and we're going to spread them out, and you want to do is make sure that, you know, you don't want to put too much, you don't want to put too little, and you want to make sure that you get a good mix of colors. So you can see I've got this beautiful purple greens in here. That purple greens, that's kind of, you know, doesn't make sense, but hey, that's the way it is, that's the way it works. So you do that to each one of these so that you've got your nice bit of colors, your nice pop of color out there, makes for some really, really beautiful and tasty tacos. So, lay this out here. Get some more color. Yeah, sometimes you'll have to dig through here to find the nice colored bits. See there, that's gorgeous. Like that. This, throw this on the other end. Pretty. So pretty. Get that out of the way. Do up the last one here. Yeah, the only problem with doing it with using pre-bagged and pre-cut greens is that, you know, you don't have as much control over the size and whatever you're doing. But it also, you know, they have a tendency to get squashed, and your green stems will get broken. So it makes for, you know, it's not quite as beautiful as it could be, but, you know, at least it's not just horrendous looking, if you know what I mean. So, there we go. We've got a decent amount on each one. Yeah, throw a little bit more spinach on this one. There we go. Beautiful. Awesome. We'll take this, put it back in the fridge. So, now that we have all that set up, this should be just done. Yeah, if that was a good few minutes, and because of the high heat and everything, I know this puppy. Oh, look at that, look at that, look at that juice. Oh yeah, isn't that gorgeous? Absolutely gorgeous. So what we're gonna do here is we're gonna cut it up into pieces that are sized for 3 tacos. So what I'm usually gonna do here is I'll take and cut this, and when you cut, you notice that it should come out nice, and oh, that is gorgeous. That is absolutely perfect. And it's still flaky, just flakes right off of the bone there. No bone, just it just flakes off. It's just flaky, nice and flaky. So I'm gonna take those, cut these ends off right down here. And those pieces will go with this piece. These pieces go over here. So it's the ways that they will fit on there. Like that. So actually throw this, we'll go in with the middle one. So I'm gonna take that. Got my tongs here. Actually, pick this up. See, that's how you can tell it's about to fall apart. It's just so beautiful and flaky. So you lean that over here on one of those. We get the next one over here. Put that right in the middle of that. Absolutely gorgeous. Now I'm going to take this last one and put it over here. And what we'll also do is we'll basically just take these, take the little pieces here, and mix and match them around so that you know, everything kind of fits up. See, beautiful right there. You know what? I'm just gonna leave those off. All right. Mm. Absolutely perfect. Beautiful, tasty. And our last step here is to take a little bit of the sriracha sauce we just made and just drizzle it nice on top here. It's really going to enhance the flavor of the swordfish. Give it a nice little bite, little kick to it. Spicy. You gotta love that. Of course, I'm one of those people, as I think, is anything's the spicier the better. Absolutely the spicier the better. So. And there we go. Let's take that and plate these up. Whoops. All right. Take this here. Like that. Be up there. And there you go. All nice and plated up. See, this is actually set up. This is for 3 people, you know, on a regular day. I haven't eaten a damn thing today. So, and it is like, it's past 10 o'clock at night, so I'm going to chow down on these puppies. But there you go. And you can't tell me that is not gorgeous. I mean, that you would not, like, just attack this the minute it came out to your table at a restaurant. I mean, absolutely beautiful food, tasty food, gorgeous food, and it will help keep people on diets, because it is all those things. I want to thank you for showing up and checking everything out. I will be back in a few weeks with another episode. And, you know, for now, I am not a chef, and you don't have to be one either. Thanks a lot.
Chops, fump, everybody eats when they come to my house. Come on!